Is something wrong, Matt?
Hey, what's on the menu?
Oh, you must be Detective Darngood.
Yeah, sorry I'm late.
Traffic out there is like murder.
It's nice to meet you. Oh, silly me. Look at that. Now let's take a look. It happened last night with a knife. We've ruled out suicide because he was in the middle of a homework assignment.
Wait.
It was a late night. The victim had been procrastinating on his assignment for days. No. Weeks. Finally, the night before it was due, he sat down to do it, but he quickly realized he was in way over his head.
I've been way over my head.
He struggled for hours, but he couldn't get anywhere. Finally, in a pressure cooker of high academic expectations and self-doubt.
I just doubt myself.
He gave.
No.
But my God, who wouldn't?
With all due respect, sir, this is no time for levity. Also, we found this.
Unfortunately, I don't think he was. Any suspects?
Well, we've narrowed down the list to a few suspects. First, there's Jonathan Notgood, the victim's roommate. He hasn't been seen on campus since last night. Contacts say he's been displaying erratic behavior for some time now. That's it. Just one suspect. Should be an easy case. But there's something we can't explain. It just doesn't make any sense.
No, it really doesn't. Anyway, I really have to be going now. This isn't much to work with, but I'll see what I can do.
Good luck, Detective.
Hey, Dick. Yeah, I'm on this, new case down in Evanston. Some kid got shanked in his room. Yeah, I was wondering if, they're sending the body to the morgue. I was wondering if you'd come up here and, do some forensic analysis on the body.
Oh, no, sorry, I can't do that. I'm busy with some other important stuff right now.
Oh. All right. Is there any way you can make it up here sometime soon?
Yeah, sorry, man. I think you're on your own.
That's all right. Peace.
Time to solve a murder case. What the heck am I doing? Detective stuff.
Don't I know you? Yeah, from the murder case. You're the guy in the lab coat. Lab coat man, yeah. Don't you remember the case back at the college, in the dorm? It's with the dumplings, yeah.
Dumplings?
Huh. Guess they used to keep his work life separate. Hello? Yeah, oh, God. Wow, that's terrible. Yeah, I'm on my way, yeah. My God, who could be responsible for such wanton destruction?
Well, whoever it is, these are his mark. We've been getting calls left and right like you can't imagine. People living alone, for the most part, but no obvious affiliations. But every time, there's a dumpling.
Well, I don't know what to make of this.
Well, you better start to. There's been a new murder every night for the past 5 days. It's not unlikely that tonight another innocent person will die. to talk. Sit down.
You got me. I thought you were going to kill me. You know, the dumpling and the table and the... Oh, man. Good one.
I am.
But you
I want to know why you ate the dumpling. Do you have any clue how long that's been out for?
A few minutes? Hours? 4 hours? 5? 6? You've been waiting here for 6 hours?
More or less.
You do this every time you kill someone?
Well, it's probably about a 5 hour average. Maybe more like 5 and a half. But it all really depends on, you know, what they're doing that night. Sometimes no one shows up and just pick a new house.
I mean, don't you have things to do? Like, Jesus Christ, you're throwing your life away. And say, where do you buy those dumplings?
Well, I actually make them myself.
They're like, they're actually really good. Like, where do you get all this time? Don't you have a job?
Well, I was up at Northwestern, and then I dropped out. Put my application all over the place, but no one really seems to be taking.
It's a tough world out there, kid. That's for sure.
You don't say.
So I suppose you know I'm Detective Darngood. If you don't mind, you are...
Jonathan Notgood.
JK.
No, I'm serious. That's my name.
So, Jonathan, how did you get yourself into this?
Well, it all started when my roommate caught me in the middle of some... unsavory behavior.
Come on, kids, get some meat. Come on around, it's a tasty treat. Kids are coming to eat my meat. Hootie doo, eat it up fast.
What?
I'm making dumplings.
You know, we didn't turn out half bad.
You want any?
No, maybe later.
He was a good kid, Matt. I suppose I should be thankful he put up with me as long as he did. And after all, it was something I did. That was the fateful moment. I looked at that dumpling for seconds that dragged on for hours. Much like you did, Detective Darngood, not 2 minutes ago, I made a move.
Did you just eat a dumpling off your desk?
No. Yes.
Okay.
Don't tell anyone.
All right.
I'm serious, don't tell anyone.
Yeah, I know. Dumpling off his desk.
He betrayed me without so much as a second thought. I should never have trusted him so blindly. Forget the shame and the agony of that day. The people I had laid my trust in were false, and the very food that I had once taken so much pride in making became my very downfall. That same day, I dropped out of school, hid myself, and began plotting my revenge. At night, I killed my roommate, but it went farther. I cooked dumplings, but I hungered for blood. And that's how it happened, Detective Darngood. That's how I got here.
And all of that, after a dumpling on a table.
The human confidence is easily damaged, Detective.
But you could have had so much. You could have been something great, made an honest living. I mean, I have a 2-year associate's degree, and I know diddly squat about what I'm doing. But I still pull in 80 grand a year, and that is darn good.
Forget it, you'll never understand.
John, I know you're gonna kill me anyway, but I just wanted to help.
Now you die, just like the rest.
Darn, I'm good! Dick, follow me.
I must say, Daniel, that was some excellent work back there. If it weren't for you, we might have never figured out who the table dumpling murderer was.
Thank you, Dick. It's funny how it all makes sense now, with the roommate and him going off the grid right around the time the murder started.
Okay.
Well, it's like the answer was in front of us the whole time. As if the case was solved before we even started on it. And yet, just a day ago, we were completely in the dark. We had no idea who the table dumpling murderer could have been.
Detective!
Lab coat, man. This is my friend and assistant, Richard Watt.
Richard?
Man, you look like a corpse.
Yeah, oh, I had a late night over in another case. Is everything okay?
Lab coat man?
I'm a medical examiner detective, if you were wondering. Anyways, I just came by to congratulate you. It looks like it was him. All along. Jonathan Notgood.
It, sure was.
Just like I may have suggested. The very beginning. You know, before five more people died. Anyways, yeah. Congratulations, Detective Darngood.
Wait. Has anyone ever told you that you, have a, killer complexion? It's uncanny.
What? Wait, where are you going?
I'm getting a coffee.
Where?
DD.
Huh?
DD, you know?
Wait, but you're DD.
What do you mean? It's coffee, not alcohol.
But you're DD, Daniel Darngood.
And you're DW, Dick Wad.
Wait, do you just call me a Dick Wad?
What's what you're called?
Who calls me Dick Wad?
Everyone does. It's your name.
Oh. Say you were getting it?
DD.
What?
Are we seriously doing this again? DD. Dunkin' Donuts.
Well, you should have just said Dunkin' Donuts.
DD's faster.
Apparently not. But hey, can I come with?
Yeah, why not?
Can we do a DT?
What?
See, now you know how I feel.
What do you mean, DT?
DT. Drive through.
No one says that.
I did.
Alright, are you coming or not?
It depends. Are we using the DT?
We don't have time for this. The credits are almost over.
The what?
The credits. Just get in the car.